a big hang wallet. I'd like to do one for you. It's called, I bought an electric tin opener, so I did, and first time I opened a tin, I cut my finger and my finger blood is over, Dad, taking the lid off the tin using the electric tin opener, so I did. So I visited, said to the surgeon, the tin lid skin grafter for a thin plaster for the tip of my bleeding finger. I says, said I cut my finger and my finger blood is over, Dad, taking off the lid of the tin using the electric tin opener, so I did. Said the surgeon, also a kitchen instrument analyst, said, with charged particles like electrons and protons, current thinking is the tin will open. I said, what have electrons and protons got to do with me needing stitching from rebuilding finger? On the kitchen bench, semi-integrated, it has a silver-white lid-retaining magnet. I said, Sid, you're in the middle of being a mitten, I need stitching from my bleeding finger. Sid doesn't seem to mind being named a mitten, and tightly grafted a grid of stitches gilded with a pyramid of plasters under the tip of my bleeding finger. Cautiously proceeding, and using the limb of a squiddy, tied the pyramid of plasters to my eyelid. And now when I wank a wank, and when I wank a wank, with my bleeding finger and my blinking eyelid, he says, there you go, it'll either get better or it'll get worse. I said, Sid, I felt a wee tiny tiddly widdly paddly bit fiddly giddly, and a bit like a timid kid, so at the surgery door I fled, so I did. And when I fled ahead, and when I had not to be it, Dad, I got rid of the squid's limb and my bleeding finger and my blinking eyelid. B, slid off the pyramid of plasters and my bleeding finger. C, undid the grid of stitches Sid had did in my bleeding finger and my blinking eyelid. D, threw the bloody electric tin opener in the bin. E, none of the above.
Eggs.
Come on, drinking my piss for you.
Eggs.
First time opened the tin, I cut the finger in my finger blood.